everything better. This is not the big legs girls, because that will make you really heavy in the bottom. So if your legs are very strong, you want to avoid this pose. So for the big legs girls, this is going to be one of the best poses, because your legs are on the side, so you can't see the real size of the pose. Yeah. This is more the girls with the streamline, so the taller girls with the smaller bodies.
Trying to create more shape, isn't it?
Yeah. Our hips are very, very small as well. So if you are very, very narrow, your hips, that will give you this extra shape over here, regardless of which leg you are in. But if you're very, like, bottom heavy,
this, but I wouldn't want to be doing that one. It's too much curve for the stage for everyone else.
Too much?
Not quite right. Okay. So I would say if you've got wide waist, wide hip, big legs, then you would want to go for this pose. As much as you can. It's much more fashion these days to get that pose. Right, so it's just about practice and stretching. Okay, so we'll do transitions after. We'll go to back pose. We've only got front and back. So back pose is pretty much standard. You want your feet shoulder width apart, and you want to get maximum duck roll you possibly can. No one's going to tell you to stand up straight on stage, however we do want to maintain a level of decency, so we want to get maximum curve, but you don't want to bend over, okay? So the curve comes from the in the pelvis as much as you can while keeping your chest up as you can. The hair usually covering the back, you can't worry about it, you don't want to do any lat spreads or anything funny. Put the hands flat on the front of the thighs. This kind of pose is a little bit outdated, I think. I would have it straight down. If you put it straight down and squeeze, you might get a little bit of shoulders coming out. That's pretty much it. You don't want to be any wider than the shoulder width. Some people are a little bit more narrow, depending on your body shape, what looks nice. It's quite a simple pose. You have got the other options where you are. You could be in a cross, like a back cross, making a little bit of a bent leg. You find that the girls use this more in transitions, I think. Or you can cross over, but I think it's a bit outdated.
Oh, the hands as well.
Yeah, you don't want hands in your thighs, not on the bum.
And not over here.
And not in here.
You can see the fingers from behind, and it looks awkward.
It's like, what is it there?
You're not sure, so.
So we are like this, maximum duck roll. So the main thing is pelvic tilt. Keep the head up. And then you're going to turn your knees out a little bit to create. You want to squeeze the bum. I don't know what those companies are doing, but some will do. Turn the knees out, you want to have a bit of tension inside the thigh, really. Unless you've got very big hamstrings, and then you don't want to do that.
Then you want to keep that straight on.
Yeah, if you've got big hamstrings, then you want to just keep the feet straight on. Alright, so go to the back to front. So you're judging your comparison are front, back, walk to the back, walk to the front, front, but that's it. So you're doing back, so your walks, forward and back into the rhythm. And front and back. So there's no side pose at all. If you really like the side pose, you can do something like that in the individual. You get an individual presentation which is 10 seconds long, and you do that first before you get the actual comparisons, which is quite nice because then you get to show yourself. You might have been on stage where you think they didn't even look at me. Or you didn't get to show your personality because it's too strict in posing, you have got 10 seconds where you can do your thing, whatever that might be, show the judges yourself. So anything that you like that you can't put in, like side pose and all that, you can put in. But for now, the comparison to front and back. So transitions from front to back. Yeah, so I guess it depends on which pose you choose. So if we go with the side pose to start with, the human horse pose, here. The way we're going to transition to the back, usually we'll step back into this pose. Here we're going to get your hip back. So it is only a transition, but we do want to make it look nice. And then we're going to go into one leg, stick the bum out as much as you can. So this foot is kind of behind the other foot, varying degrees of, and hand in front. And then we're going to go into back pose. So step, step, go with the back. So we're in back pose. We're going to turn to face the front. So, Karina's going to go over there. Again, there's no rules on this. You can turn how you like. we're in the pose still. You don't have to be on this side, I'm on this side because I like it. You might like it on this side. So choose the side that you like and you're more comfortable with. If you're doing it this side, the transition is the same, the other way. So we go back. girls love that, you can say. Won't be like that.
They want to see it flow, so it's more like a dance. Not too much with the arms, but just to make it feel
easy.
Yeah.
And sometimes a pose, which you think looks good in the mirror, does not look quite so good here, or even just a fraction. So we think about, when you're actually a 360 person by the picture, that's quite important. Something I did not even realise until I got confused myself.
Into angles, I thought. Like this.
Yeah.
Oh, I wasn't posing.
Alright, so you're going to angle. Karina's in the mirror.
So I'm in the mirror. So you're trying to do your front pose at me.
Yeah, I can use the camera to do a progress picture. See ya. Doing an angle action there. And just getting used to it when you practice doing it in different angles, maybe without them or at different things. Because you get on stage and you lose. There's not much to look at. You're doing a colour, but it's not the right direction. And then you lose marks. You look like you're sick face and you have different angles. You walk diagonal onto the stage, to the middle. There's no bit at the back where you want to walk. Walk straight off from the stage, where that might be, to the middle, do your stuff, and then off.
10 seconds.
It says 10 seconds, so
it's pretty much front, back, front, and behind.
Yeah. It's slightly like 12 seconds, I'm not sure about it.
No.
But
it can't be half a minute, it can't be like,
yeah, you don't want to too much. Very wide.